that we all have, and I think most of us follow, is to try and eat as in moderation and to make sure that you're eating natural and you're eating home-cooked meats. I think home-cooked, natural and moderation has to be the way we move. Moderation, but I think Thoda Kam is more than just a slogan. Thoda Kam has to be government regulations as are done across the world, where food has to be labeled individually so that all of us have the right to know. The right knowledge is critical for nutrition, for good nutrition and good food. And this is why across the world, including in India, we now have a draft labeling regulation, which will require us to have information front of the pack which tells us what is it, what does that food have in terms of salt, sugar, fat. That right to know is what Thoda Kam is about. We've spoken about it, but I think the most important thing right now is that we should try and avoid food which is high in salt, sugar, fat. Junk food is something that has to be called junk. We cannot now work around our way around it by calling it all sorts of strange names. It's junk. And the fact is, this food is bad for us, and that more and more, and particularly mothers, because all data and surveys shows that mothers are actually both eating bad and getting children to eat bad. So it's very critical that the label is read and that a percentage of your daily diet has to be understood. So if you have a bottle of a cola, you need to understand it's 2 days quota of your sugar. Or if you have a package of processed noodles, you need to know it's 75% of the daily salt quota of your child, which means the rest of the day has to be boiled vegetables. Quota of the FSSAI movement, but only because it is based on regulation. It is very critical that consumer information has to be based on the government putting out clear regulation on how companies will label food and what will consumers know. That is the role of FSSAI, and that, in my view, is the key message of this movement.